Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Zach Datto, and I am doing my Gens 124 capstone PowerPoint presentation. Yes. My three areas of improvement must be punctual, turn in assignments on time, need to pay more attention, which is one of my really big weak spots. Right. As I will go into this, the ones that I picked for my capstone outline topics mainly are describe three areas of improvement and how you realize each you need. One of the improvements I needed to do was getting to class in time. What I realized I needed to get was a proper sleeping schedule. Another improvement to be desired was not turning in some assignments. My realization for that was starting to cut time for various procrastinations in my life. My third improvement was that I needed to pay more attention on what was going on in my class. I realized I temporarily stopped whatever I was doing and pay attention and take notes if necessary. Then struggles I've experienced. Oh, right. For this one, the topic is number four. Describe three struggles you experienced in this class and how you dealt with them. Here are the quick ones right there. Anyways, struggle number one was not coming to class in time anywhere. Struggle number one was not coming to class in time at worst, missing more than 50% of the class by being almost 50 minutes late. Because of spending time with friends, I procrastinated too much. And thus then, I felt very bad during that day. For a resolution for that, I made a SMART goals checklist. I made a second checklist to reduce 25% of my 25% of spending time with my friends in order to regain my academic momentum. And thus it really helped out. Struggle number two was too many procrastinations, which distracted me from my too many procrastinations. My procrastinations were playing video games, watching lots and lots of anime, and hanging out with friends, which is, these are usually no-nos whenever I have school assignments due. Do them first, then I can do all the rest, is what I should have done. My grades would have been two times better than they are now, times two. Anyways, I made a SMART goals checklist for that one as well, if I hadn't mentioned that already. All right. Identify three strengths that you possess and how this class utilized or challenged these attributes. My devotion toward things, my jolly fat self, charisma. Strength one. My first strength is my devotion towards things. When there are things I like, I tend to put my all into them. No matter what they are or how difficult they are, if I like them, I will do them to most of my abilities. This class made me... This class made me spend time doing more homework. This class made me spend time doing homework and studying more than I ever would have when I was in high school. Only near the end of high school, when it was finals, did I truly actually did study. So I have no idea how I survived high school either. But somehow I'm here. Miracles. Anyway, struggle or strength. Strength number two. I'm fat. I'm not athletic. I chose to utilize this into one of my assignments, the 32-day SMART goals. My 32-day SMART goal is to exercise in my fast fitness class at certain times during every week. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday, starting at 3:10. My third strength is charisma. I have a few friends that either go to my house or I hang out with often this week, often every week. This class challenged me to reduce that time that I have spent with them in exchange for better academics. And in doing so, I have partially regained some academic momentum. Thanks to looking at various examples and talking with some peers, I put the background story last. So I put the main important stuff first. Anyways, this is my backgrounds, where I lived. Saipan. Saipan is a small island near the Marianas Islands. It's near the Marianas Trench, the deepest trench in the world. These are my old hobbies before I came over here. I would often buy every month generic airsoft guns. They would always break on me, and it was kind of pricey. So, same with Nerf guns and water guns. I got into those because there's nothing really to do in Saipan. It does have beautiful beaches though. Just gorgeous sands, waters. It's a very nice place to go to. Scuba diving, fishing, you name it, if it's something to do with the beach. It's very, very nice. And finally, these are my passions in life. These are the things that keep me going and are my strengths and weaknesses. My sword, my double-edged sword, and my shield as well. These helped me through times when life was being too heavy. I was worried about my future, that it would crush me and I would cry every now and then, scared, really, really scared about my future. And then these came along and these helped. They kept me going. These are the various genres of anime that I really, really love. I love magical girls. I love fantasy. I love dramas. This is drama and fantasy put together. That's drama, romance, comedy, and that one over there as well. Girl with the glasses. These are my mementos. or mementos. Like, I have a whole bunch of anime stuff, but I didn't want to bring my entire collection over here, because that would be a pain. These are what you call manga. These are basically Japanese comic books, yet they're very, very good. They have very enriching stories and are very nice. Here, I'll pass this around for people to look at. The way they work is you read them the opposite way than when you usually read a book. And they're not really colored pages, but they're very, the art in them is really good, and I enjoy that. Yes, that's for manga. Light novels are basically the book versions of them. And yes, basically the book pictures, less pictures, more words, basically. They're really good as well. I enjoy them. Well, that is the end of my presentation.
All right. Questions, comments, thoughts for Zach?
What are you majoring in college?
What am I majoring in college? What I'm majoring in college, so far I don't have too much of an idea since I just got here and this is my first year. My parents brought me over here. So I have a little bit more time to think.
Would you consider a degree possibly in art since manga is your favorite?
That could be a realm of possibility.
Maybe storytelling? You can come up with a script and someone can draw for you?
Oh, yeah. That would be a great idea, actually. I need to become creative, but that's what I'm here in college for. Increase creativity in many ways.
Carl, go ahead.
I was just thinking one of the things you could do if you don't have the creative side for manga is you could also do the there's also the production side, like working with the soundboards, editing.
Yes, there's that.
Because if you've got the, like the gaming computer knowledge, that might be a direction with that.
Yeah, you can work with video games.
Yes. My mom's also said she'd like me to work in a video game company and stuff. It's very, very, yes, that's a good idea right there. Well, if anything, I might do some more computer classes first around the CIS 100 areas, CIS classes. I might. There's still all the other stuff I need to take care of. Any more questions?
Of course, I have questions for you. So, first is kind of a comment. You're absolutely correct. In the beginning of the quarter, you were coming in late. There was a lot of procrastination. And about, I'd say, halfway through the quarter, after we started working on those goals, you could see things change, where you were showing up on time, you were starting to go to your fast fitness course, and you were making a concerted effort. It really shows when you would show up into the art building to the study labs. So that's really powerful to see you being able to change your action there, okay? So that's something that you definitely want to carry on. I really enjoyed your SMART goal also, where you have an actual percentage of how much you wanted to pull away from friends and all the fun things that you were doing. So you didn't make an unrealistic goal and just said, hey, I'm going to cut out my friends and all the fun stuff totally. I'll cut out about 25% and I'm going to dedicate that time there. Okay. It also showed, even though this is another class in the Digital 101, where when you were putting on your action plan, you were articulating, look, from 8 to 9 p.m. on this day, I was studying this. From 4 to 5 p.m., I was doing this. So it was your actions started matching what you were saying, right? And so I think that's really powerful. So the question that I have for you is, do your friends support you being a college student?
Oh, yes, they definitely do. I mean, some of them, like at first they were saying, Zach's going to college? He's not built for college. He might not survive. And I feel so sorry for you. No, why? Then they also talked to my mom. Why are you throwing him in college? He's not going to make it. And all that. But realistically, or as long as I can start from zero and build my way up again, hopefully I can survive in this place called college and find some future.
So do your friends hold you accountable? Do they say, hey, Zach, let's not hang out right now. You need to do some schoolwork. Do you think they'll get to that point?
Yes, they give me space when necessary at times. And sometimes they say, hey, are you doing your work and stuff? Every now and then, and I say, okay, yes, I'm doing this work.
Good. All right. The other thing that I wanted to say to you is, and really it's more to the class, and you're a pretty quiet person in class. Mm-hmm. However, I have the privilege of seeing the work that you submit, and I comment on your work. And it's probably not until today, until a lot of people can see the person that's inside of you, right? Your presentation was wonderful. You know, you were very self-reflective. Your self-analysis was spot on. What you can do about that going forward is you articulated yourself very well. And I think that's missing sometimes when we don't have a lot of space to have the group work or, you know, you're not being forced to be called on in class. Right, but there's so much to you that's inside of you that I think that people really can't capture until today. Mm-hmm. So I'm glad that you were here and you presented so everyone can see that.
Yes. Yes, there is the nervousness and everything in my presentation, obviously. But yes, I tried to do as much as I could in the situation that I have. Of course, there'll be more improvements in the future. This is just the beginning.
You did great, and you have humor, right? That's hard to pull off.
I have humor?
Yeah. Are there any other questions or comments for Zach? All right, applause. All right.